subscribers and viewers of OWUUBII channel, I want to welcome you once more to this wonderful channel. In this video, I'm going to show you an Android app I've been using called the WIFI analyzer. This software is able to analyze WIFI signals around. Okay, it's able to check the WIFI signal strength. It's able to know the kind of WIFI password encryption it uses and the rest. So please, let's go detail into how this software actually works. Okay, first of all, let's tackle the settings before we come to how we can view it in various forms. So let's get into the settings. So the first thing you'll notice at the settings part of it is a scan automatically, simply meaning if I should disable this right now and we go back, we aren't going to see any activity on the dashboard here. Okay, it means we have to scan manually, but when we go back and then we highlight it back to scan automatically and we go back, we are going to see various WIFI signals here. Okay, so that is one thing about the settings with relation to scan automatically. When it is unchecked, it means you are going to scan manually. The next thing is to scan interval. Under the scan interval, we have various levels. We have the level 0, which is the shortest. We have level 1 all the way to level 5, which is the longest. Okay, it has all got to do with the WIFI scan interval. If we go down here, we have the channel settings. This has got to do with 2.4 gigahertz WIFI channels. Okay, and so these are by default checked. Okay, if you uncheck any of the WIFI channels here, it means even if there is any channel which is present with regards to the one you unchecked, it means you are not going to see it when you scan the WIFI signals. Okay, you have the use channel width. If you uncheck it, so basically it's an experimental feature of the software. It uses a channel width values reported by the device to draw and compute. This is basically the info we can get with regards to use channel width. And then the next thing is the user interface settings. If we select the immersive mode, it's going to the interface of the software is going to change into a different mode, but we don't want it that way. The next one is the keep screen on. Basically prevent the screen from automatically turning off. This feature is basically going to drain your battery. Okay, it says open network indicator, draw an asterisk after the name SSID of open WIFI in graph. Yeah, it is unchecked. If you check it, this is what you are going to get from it. It goes on and on. We have the fail channel graph. Does a fill parabolas with transparency, it is checked. Then here we have the colors. So here you can delete certain colors you don't want, you can add certain colors. Example like this, you can just come here and select any color you want. Okay, any color combination. Okay, these colors are in connection to the WIFI signals you are going to see. Okay, You can delete any of these colors if you don't want any. Right, we have the merge duplicated APs. Okay, merge APs with the same BSSID, SSID channel and security into one. And so if we check this, it means it's going to merge all APs bearing the same name and then the same password. Okay, and it's already checked. We have group mode for list. It displays APs with the same SSID security as groups in AP list view, and then show full securities. When it's checked, we are going to see the security detail about the particular access point. It goes on and on and on, but let's focus on the reason why I opened this software. So basically, these are the various forms by which you can watch and analyze the various Wi-Fi's you are going to see on this software. The first one is the channel graph. If you select the channel graph, you are going to see things like this. Okay, you're going to see statistics like this, the signals strength in terms of the dBm. Okay, let's go back there. The next one is the time graph. Okay, then we have the channel rating. So let me say I want to select this particular access point. Okay, so it tells me something good about this access point. All the channels are good, they are in their excellent mode. Okay, if we go further, AP list, it's able to give me details. Okay, it's able to give me details of the access point. The gateway, the network, the DNS, the server IP, the link speed, okay, on the Wi-Fi access point. And if I want to copy, I just have to click copy to clipboard. Okay, we have various access points here. So funny enough, it comes with the name of their brands. So example, if I no thanks, I don't want to connect to it. You see, it's from here you can even connect directly to the access point, provided you have access to the password of those access points. If we come down, this is the part which I like most because it has to do with sound. It has to do with beeping sounds. And so if I enable the sound, we are going to hear very loud beeping sounds with regards to the strength of the Wi-Fi signal it's going to connect to. Okay, if it is strong, it is going to beep hard. The lower it is, the lower the beeping sounds. The higher it goes, the higher the beeping sounds. Okay, so in a jiffy, we are going to hear this beeping sound. So basically this is how the software works. Okay, this is all it entails with regards to this software. So you can go ahead and do a snapshot of it, take view, save view and stuff like that. You can send tools, learn neighbors. So let's try this and see. So these are my learn neighbors. I like this software. It's able to tell you the IP range of the Wi-Fi access point you've connected to, or the router you've connected to. Okay, so basically it's able to give us some details with regards to our LAN neighbors. If we go further with the OUI, okay, this has got to do with MAC address lookup. So basically this is how this software works. Okay, and the name of the software is Wi-Fi Analyzer. Okay, I'm going to share the link down in my description for you guys to download it and use it. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like my videos, share my videos, and your comments are expected. Thank you.